Hello, I'm Dr. Emma Hitt Nichols, and this is an AMA Manual of Style Guide tip that I hope will be useful to medical writers and also to our clients at Nascent Medical, that's my company. Please share with your colleagues if you find it useful. This week, I am going to go over a checklist for tables. This is based on information at Section 1, Preparing an Article for Publication, Subsection, Visual Presentation of Data, 4.1 Tables. If you're fiercely interested in this topic, you should really check it out from the source. I've included most, but not all of the finer details, okay? All right, so the first thing is to make primary comparisons horizontal rather than vertical. During the planning and creation of a table, the author should show the primary comparisons horizontally across the table, which makes them easier to compare. And if you look at two tables which are displayed correctly and incorrectly, you'll see that the reader can compare differences in a much easier way when it's done properly. The second is to limit the amount of information presented in a single table and use multiple tables if necessary. For the sake of clarity, you really do want to limit the amount of information presented and use more than one table if needed. In general, tables in print publications can, depending on the content, contain up to 9 to 10 columns of data, which includes the first left-hand column or stub. Cells that contain words will be wider, thereby reducing the number of columns that will fit, so keep that in mind also. Number 3, indent stubs to depict hierarchy. Stubs should be left justified, and indentations can be used to depict hierarchical components of the stubs. However, some publications use bold stubs or shading instead, which is fine. Number 4, line up data with the first line in the stub entry. Pretty self-explanatory. Number 5, use a suitable title with a correct format. If a manuscript contains only one table, it's referred to in the text as table. If there is more than one table, you would number it 1, 2, 3, etc. sequentially throughout the text. Table titles should use the title case, words 4 or more letters capitalized. The title should convey the topic of the table succinctly, but should not provide detailed background information or summarize or interpret the results. Number 6, you should shorten column titles and expand abbreviations in a footnote if needed. In column headings, style guidelines regarding numbers and abbreviations may be relaxed somewhat to save space, with abbreviations expanded in the footnote. However, when space does allow, you should spell out headings, and expansions are preferable to abbreviations. Superscripted letters A through Z should be used sequentially based on the order of placement in the table of the item to which the footnote refers. You can take a look at this table as an example. The placement of the footnote is tied to what is included in the reference. For example, in this table, the letter I is at the end of the subsection header because the detail in the footnote refers to that entire subsection. Number 7, use correct units of measure. In tables, units of measure, including the variability of the measurement if reported, should follow a comma in the table column heading or stub. Number 8, modify punctuation as needed, either for space or clarity. Punctuation may be abbreviated in tables to save space. For example, slashes may be used to present dates, such as 1/24/19 instead of January 24, 2019. Phrases and sentences in tables may use end punctuation if required for readability. For example, if cells contain multi-sentence entries. Number 9, use abbreviations properly. Abbreviations can be used, however, spelled out words should not be combined with abbreviations for units of measure. For example, you should not use first Y. Instead, you'd say first year, fully spelled out, or year one. Abbreviations or acronyms should also be explained in a footnote. Number 10, present numbers accurately. It's not possible to go into detail here, but the AMA manual includes a lengthy discussion of how to present numbers accurately in any kind of medical writing, not just tables, and these same rules apply. For example, additional digits, including zeros, should not be added after the decimal point to provide all data entries with the same number of digits. Doing this may indicate more precise results than actually were calculated or measured. In most cases, p-values should be expressed to two digits to the right of the decimal point, unless the first two digits are zeros, in which case three digits to the right of the decimal place should be provided. But do check out the AMA style guide for all the information on that. Well, that's it for now. Thank you so much for joining me. If you need medical writing assistance, please check out our website, nascentmc.com, nascentmc.com. And if you're interested in getting into medical writing as a career, then please visit 6weekcourse.com, numeral 6weekcourse.com. Thanks so much.